When it comes to talking about movies, there's always that cult film that everyone loves. Most cult films are classics that are loved by so many people for being really well-made films. Then there's films that have gained a reputation for being so bad that they're actually enjoyable. And then there are films that are hated by so many people, but only a few people dependent. For me, that's 2005's Day. Released in late 2005, this psychological thriller stars Ryan Gosling, Ewan McGregor, Naomi Watts, and Bob Hoskins. The film centers around a college student named Henry Latham, played by Gosling, who plans to kill himself due to feeling guilty for his parents' death. All the while, the psychiatrist Sam Foster, played by McGregor, tries to save him, and throughout, strange occurrences start happening. It's directed by Mark Foster and is written by. Actually, I forgot who it was written by. Let me check. It's probably by this unknown guy no one's ever heard of. Let's see.
David Benioff? As in this David Benioff?
Yeah, the guy who wrote one of the worst seasons in television history and disrespected the work of one of the most famous authors around, wrote the script for this film. Good job! You actually subverted my expectations. I'm not joking, he actually did it. Anyways. Stay has been criticised for the choices that were made, and at first glance, it's understandable. The wooden performances, aside from Gosling, who's giving it his all, random editing choices, the really questionable cinematography, even Ewan McGregor's trousers being high for like no reason. It makes sense just by focusing on these aspects why people hate it, but there's a reason why it's there. You just need to watch the ending and think. I see this film the same way as I do with both Enemy and Donnie Darko. They're not films you can easily watch. You basically need to read between the lines and analyse what's happening. And by doing that, you can appreciate them even more. Same thing with Stay. Reading between the lines is important when talking about thought-provoking films. When this film was released, critics agreed on Stay as being pretentious and more of an art piece than a film. To this day, it still holds bad reviews on different film sites. At the time, the only person to get it was Roger Ebert, who understood what it was about and what it was trying to do. Actually, a lot of cult films we love today were initially met with bad reviews when they came out. It wasn't until years later they gained the respect that they do now. So my question is, if films like 2001, Fight Club, and even Predator are praised all these years later, and even the films I mentioned, which is basically the same tone and the same genre, if those films can be appreciated, why hasn't the same thing happened to Stay? Honestly, I think it's a shame that not many people know about this film. I think it's a really underrated thriller. It has one of the best performances I've seen, especially from Ryan Gosling. I think the story is really interesting and I think it's really well told, and I really admire the attention to detail it has throughout every scene. Even the soundtrack done by H.M. Spencer is really good. I was actually listening to it as I was doing the script for this video. If you plan on watching Stay, I highly suggest you do. You can find it on Amazon for a really cheap price, or you can find it on the PSN store, which is how I found it. Who knows, maybe in a few years it will be seen differently. But I guess only time will tell.